having trouble trying to sleep. I'm counting sheep but running out. As time ticks by, still I try. No rest for hot tops in my mind. On my own, here we go.
We'll be right back. All right. Let's begin. Hello.
How have you been?
I missed you. Starting still in turnabout today, it would seem. What's going on? Still in turnabout.
Meanwhile.
Time is 1 a.m. Got Mario Kart sound effects in here. Detective, we made it. Ugh, what a relief. Now the jewel is still safe. Agamshu. You said it, pal. Must have been a rock solid security that scared him off. Would you mind opening the safe just to double check? Ah! We've been had! Out front! Guards! Turn on the searchlights!
Oh boy. Good luck next time, gentlemen. Oh boy, it's Turnabout Big Top all over again. Excuse me, but I'm afraid I must be leaving now. Shall meet again when the next moon is full. October 11th, 3:24 p.m., Renko offices.
Oh, hey, Nick, get a load of this! Hey, are you listening to me? You can clean the toilet later. This is important.
What are you freaking out about now?
So it'll be the last time you talk to me that way.
Huh?
We're about to hit the big time.
Big time? And what do you mean by we? You don't mean you and me, or...
Heh, don't be silly. I'm talking about me and... Burley, of course. Hello, it's a pleasure to see you again, Mr. Nick. Pearls, you haven't changed a bit.
Wait, what are you doing here anyway?
Haven't you heard, Mr. Nick? Here, take a look at this.
What's this? Some kind of poster? Crane Village, isn't that? Oh,
I am. Amy.
Never thought we'd be seeing that urn again. Isn't that?
That's right. It's our hometown.
Well, apparently in mine, that is. But what's this about treasures from the boonies?
Very funny. You can laugh all you want. We'll be singing another tune tonight. Tonight? What about tonight?
The Treasures of Corinth exhibit doesn't actually start until next week, but
the promoter sent us some special VIP entry passes. That's why I dressed up extra special today.
What do you think, Nick?
You're wearing the same thing you always do.
Heh. Same Maya, different day.
This young lady here is Maya Faye.
The younger sister of Mia Faye, my friend and mentor. I first met her 2 years ago. I was working on the case surrounding Mia's death, and ever since then,
I've been the one who's been keeping this law office afloat from behind the scenes.
Actually, that's just a cover for her true identity. In reality, she's a spirit medium and a bit of a shady character.
Well, hey, who are you calling shady?
And this little girl is Pearl Faye, but I usually call her Pearls. She's Maya's cousin and a spirit medium in training herself.
I know I'm a bit young, but I want to help in any way I can, Mr. Nick.
Korean Village is the home of the mysterious Korean Chalak technique. Maya here is the daughter of the Korean school of Chalak's master. I know it sounds ridiculous, but it's no joke. I've seen her power with my own eyes. It's the real thing, alright.
Mr. Nick, how long are you gonna make two gorgeous women like us wait? Yeah, Mr. Nick, can't wait any longer. I want to see the exhibit.
Looks like I don't get a choice here. Might as well head on out. Treasure exhibit poster. October 11th, 7:18 p.m. Lord Lee Taylor. What kind of name is that? Exhibit all. Lord Lee Taylor? The city's fanciest and most expensive department store. Treasure exhibit, huh? I have to admit, I'm pretty impressed.
Wow. This is awesome.
Yeah.
You can make even the cheapest junk look great.
All depends on how you display it.
Oh, they even have the dusty old hanging scroll that was in the Fae Manor storeroom. Oh yeah, I remember scribbling on it when I was a little girl.
On a family heirloom?
Say, Nick. The person in charge of this exhibition is waiting for us in the basement warehouse.
Alright. I wish we should go and say hello. Oh boy. Basement warehouse.
Yep, this is a basement warehouse, alright.
This place is scary. I feel like a monster could jump out at any time.
Don't be scared, Pearly, I'll protect you.
Oh.
Mr. Rock.
Ah! A monster, you were right. Huh? A monster?
Oh, Adrian!
Good evening. It's good to see you again.
You. I know you.
Nice to see you again, little miss.
What? Hello!
Is she a friend of yours, Nick? And how do you know her, Pearly? Nice to meet you. I'm Adrian Andrews. I'm in charge of the promotion and planning for a Strider exhibit. I'm also responsible for the security arrangements.
Nice to meet you.
Adrian sure has changed since we last met. This is the warehouse. The really valuable exhibit items are still stored away in here. Hold on. Give me a second.
Well, it has been a long time, hasn't it, Mr. Wright?
Nick, what's going on? Who is this woman?
Why are you freaking out on me?
What?
I just thought it'd be more dramatic if I got all worked up, that's all.
Mystic Maya, you shouldn't let him off the hook so easily.
Please, Maya, don't say anything that'll needle Pearls further.
Mr. Wright was there for me when I really needed help. It was something that happened 7 months ago. You remember, don't you? The Knuckle Samurai case? Alright. Have a profile on everything. Hell, they even got Phoenix in here.
Not really. I was stuck in a dark wine cellar. Did that escape your memory, Nick?
I'm in the Discord. I was talking to Dark Wine Cellar. Did I escape your memory, Nick?
After that, I quit being a manager and started this job.
Well, that's tough. I'm sorry, Miss Andrews.
If it wasn't for us.
No, no, don't say that. I'm glad the whole thing happened. Thanks to you and everyone else that was involved, I was able to change my whole life. I really am grateful.
That's a relief.
I'm really impressed, Miss Andrews. Handling a huge exhibition like this must be very tiring.
Well, Lordly Taylor's celebrating their 200th anniversary this year. Oh, Jesus.
The works on display in the main exhibition hall are worthy of the finest museums.
Okay, I'm sorry. Give me a second.
Alright. Nice museums. Yeah, I did. That's really wonderful. So, this basement warehouse is pretty well protected, huh?
Of course it is. After all, there are some priceless treasures here. Security guards are all really highly trained as well.
Sounds good. So, what is with that face she's making?
Megatama and... Yeah.
Present anything to her? I guess not. I guess we can. It says Organi.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. It says organize. You just can't see the last two letters.
Yeah, well, no one. I guess no one else can read it either because this place is a mess.
Yeah, you must feel right at home, huh? Mystic Maya, take a look next to the door. That's Mystic Amy, right?
Yes, that's the statue of the woman who invented the crane channeling technique, Amy Faye. The statue was on loan from one of the training halls of the Faye branch family. In fact, it just arrived this morning. It is holding the Shichi sheet.
What's that creepy looking thing she's holding? Well, don't ask me! How should I know?
Weird looking sword. Alright.
Okay.
Alright, take your time.
Well, you are the future master, right? Maybe so, but this is the first time I've ever seen the statue.
That thing is the Karin Shichi Shito. It's a ceremonial sword. It's not a real weapon, so the blade isn't sharp.
Ah, oh, Philly. I want to cut something!
I want to cut too many things.
What are you eyeing me for?
Oh boy.
Oh, look, it's already 8 p.m. Have you all eaten yet?
Well, actually, I've already made a reservation at the restaurant on the 12th floor.
Why don't we all dine together? Oh, I like the sound of that. Dine, it sounds so fancy. I'll have the kids' lunch.
Pearly, it's dinner, not lunch. Why don't you go for it and really eat your fill of the kids' dinner?
Oh, okay, in that case, one's kids' dinner for me.
Shall we head upstairs then?
After that pleasant evening, all that remained was to wait for the exhibition's opening. It was wonderful seeing Miss Andrews looking so happy. None of us could have imagined that the very next day, something terrible would happen.
October 12th, 10:09 a.m., Reagan Co. Law offices.
Nick, this is terrible! What the? You're cleaning the toilet again? I never knew you were such a toilet freak.
Bro, why do you even?
Give me a break, would you? My brain just hit the snooze button for the fifth time. I'm gonna turn on the TV.
We've got an update on the recent treasure heist. Based on clues right at the scene of the crime, authorities have announced that they believe it was work of the renowned Phantom Thief.
Phantom Thief. Now I'm getting Vietnam flashbacks.
Right. Mask the mask.
Mask?
According to a spokesperson, Lord Lee Taylor received a threat letter some days ago. This is the fifth heist by this Phantom Thief, who only targets rare treasures.
Lord Lee Taylor?
Well, Nick, what are you gonna do? Don't you dare go back to scrubbing the toilet!
Treasure? Lord Lee Taylor? Oh, you don't think!
Yes! Now get up, Nick! It was stolen by Mask the Mask! Most valuable treasure. The Grand Sacred Urn was stolen! What?
Oh boy. Back, cool. Alright, refresh my memory a little. What's this Sacred Urn?
It's only the most important treasure in Crane Village.
Hello, Rachel. That's all.
Look, it's right there on this poster.
I remember that. Don't you remember what's inside? The urn contains a very important soul. Namely, the soul of Mystic Amy Faye, the founder of the Crane Challenge Technique. Why is Maya in court again?
Yeah, she is. She's just... Look, Maya is free. She works here. She's working with us.
I can call the offices.
Right, Pearly? Yes, that's right!
Hold up. I thought that urn had the name Amy written on it. Now it says I am.
Any idea how that happened, Pearly?
Oh, I know all too well how that happened.
There are some things best left unsolved, wouldn't you say, Mr. Nick?
Oh, that's right. 1 year ago, there was a murder in Kareem Village, Maya's hometown. The Sacred Urn turned out to be an important clue in that case. The Sacred Urn, supposedly priceless, looks like a plain old pot.
Okay, the toilet is shinier than the judge's heads.
So let's see what's next.
What's wrong with you, Nick?
What do you mean?
What do you mean with it, Mr. Nick? Your beloved Mystic Maya's treasure's been stolen. Doesn't that even bother you?
But I thought the urn was the village's treasure, so I don't see how...
The village is Mystic Maya! She's the future master of the Korean School of Channeling! You know what I'm talking about, Mr. Nick? I won't let you say you don't. Okay. I do.
So what am I supposed to do about it?
Isn't it obvious? Go for the bad guy who did this! Well, yeah, and get the sacred urn back.
But I'm not a detective, I'm a lawyer.
That has nothing to do with this! If you're a real gentleman, you would find it for your beloved Mystic Maya.
Man, oh man, there's no winning against Pearl's fairy tale image of love. So, what's the name of this bad guy again?
Mask the Mask, Nick. Make a note of it, Mask the Mask.
What a stupid name.
Oh, it was terrible, I was arrested and everything.
One year ago, the murder in Crane Village. A man was killed during one of my spirit channelings. And this urn wound up being the key piece of evidence that proved her innocence. I really...
Ren! No, no, wait, sorry. Charlie!
Did I do it right?
Mr. Nick? Would you mind not telling Mystic Maya about that? You promised, remember? You said you wouldn't tell anyone I broke the urn.
Great job. You just said it out loud. Oh, yeah, that's right. Now I remember the urn used to say Amy on it. Yeah. Yeah, maybe I'll get used to it soon. I don't know. Until Pearl's accidentally broken into a million pieces. That doesn't look like a million. That looks like 20. No, just 20. She tried to secretly fix it. Let's just say it didn't work out so well.
Sorry, not so good at arts and crafts. Spelling either.
Anyway, this is how her gluing project turned out. She put the pieces together wrong, and now it says... And now instead of Amy, it says I am.
So you're missing, you got a snack? Okay.
I can't believe no one's noticed this until now, a whole year later.
I can't believe it myself.
Right.
Right.
See if we can find some clues on my list to the bad guy.
But it doesn't look like anything has been disturbed.
Yeah, it looks pretty much the same as it did last night.
Bad guy, huh?
Hey! You can't poke around here, pal!
Wait a minute. That voice.
Oh no, not him again!
Gumshoe!
It's you! And I'm the one who should be saying not again!
Wait, did you? Oh god. What have you done?
Why is it that every time something bad happens, you always show up, pal?
I should be asking you that. Aren't there any other detectives?
No, I should be asking you that! What are you doing hanging around here?
Hey, I asked you first. Why are you here any-
Alright, we got it. Why don't you two kiss and make up already?
Hello. It's been a long time, Mr. Scruffy Detective.
Oh, it's you, little missy. Actually, my name is Gumshoe. Detective Dick Gumshoe. That was a good chance for you to try and remember it right.
And if it's too long for you, you could just call him
Dick.
Okay, it's good to see you again, Mr. Detective.
Dick.
Yeah, good to see you again too, I guess.
What happened?
I'm not gonna get used to this.
Mr. Detective's Dick, can you tell us about what happened?
Oh, you're trying to remember my name. Ha, girl, it's Gumshoe, okay? Anyway, the thief stole something called the, Sacred Urn.
I know about that.
Oh. Well, the criminal's name is Mask the Mask.
I know about that too.
Detective, can't you tell us something other than that? Well, I guess I sort of kind of owe you guys. Well, in a way.
The crime occurred last night at around, let's say, 1:30 in the morning.
How exactly do you know that?
We got an emergency phone call from a guard at the scene of the crime, pal.
He said, the urn was just stolen!
What?
The scene of the crime? You mean here, right?
Wrong.
That urn was being kept under
careful guard in the basement warehouse.
Basement warehouse, huh?
So who was guarding the basement warehouse? Well, that guy! It's all his fault that the thief got away, pal! He solves one case and gets a swelled head, thinking that he's an ace detective!
Are you talking about Junpei Yori? No, maybe Naoto Shiragane. Or, I don't know, it could be Goro Akechi. I don't know who you're talking about.
But the way you're describing it, it sounds like Junpei Yori.
Ace Detective?
Oh shit, you lost your headphones, oh god. Hey, Detective Gumshoe, about this mask-to-mask stupid name. Is he famous?
What? You're joking, right, Nick? Mask-to-mask is the hottest thing since sliced bread! Sometimes he appears as a museum guard! Sometimes he appears as a big robber, known to surprise unsuspecting victims! Or he those disguises as the true mask-to-mask!
So he's some kind of master of disguise, huh? And he only goes after the finest works of art, pal! Last night was his fifth heist! If Lordly Taylor only cooperated, I could have got him this time!
What? Then he knew he was planning on stealing the sacred urn?
Of course I did! The guy always says his calling card before he steals something!
Calling card, huh? They mentioned that on TV. They mentioned Phantom Thief, now they mention calling card. Oh boy. Well, now I'm getting more flashbacks.
So why do you call him an ace detective anyway?
Well, that's what he calls himself, pal.
I didn't make it up.
So, what's he like?
Well, like I told you, Mask to Mask has made 5 heists so far.
On the 4th heist, Mr. Ace Detective, Mr. Junpei Yori managed to get the stolen treasure back.
Wow, that is impressive. All by himself?
Yeah. I gotta admit it, pal. Maybe he really is as good as he says. Every time the thief sends one of his calling cards, we send our men out on a stakeout. But none of us has ever gotten so much as a glimpse of the guy.
But Mr. Ace Detective was able to retrieve the stolen treasure from the thief.
Anyway, he's at the scene of the crime right now, looking for clues.
So he's down in the basement warehouse, huh?
So what's this calling card?
Oh, here it is. But don't show it to anyone, it's top secret, okay, pal?
What's this mark on the front?
Well, that's Mask to Mask's signature emblem, pal. You could say it's his mark. All of his calling cards have got it on them.
They didn't mention that on the newsflash.
We're withholding that detail from the public for operational reasons.
The only way we can tell is if a calling card is real or not is by this album.
Alright. That makes sense. When you get famous,
there are always imitators.
Oh, Mr. Nick, if you work a little harder, maybe you can have your own copycat someday.
Thanks, I guess.
Dude. There we go.
No matter how many times we come here, this place always gives me the chills. That's probably because it's air-conditioned.
Well, to protect the art pieces, you know.
Welcome to my private little banquet of chaos!
Huh?
What the hell does that mean?
Oh boy.
I'm afraid I saw your little fiasco in a picture show, and I just couldn't resist. What a performance! Why, I haven't seen anything like that since the stock market crash of 1929!
So many orphans. He has a lightning bolt for...
Thank you, Kaminari! I'm afraid I have very little to offer, but please, make yourself at home.
Who are you anyway? Just silence! Oh boy. Now I see, it's all becoming clear! What do you see? Zvari! The truth has once again been elegantly revealed to me. A lawyer and a spirit medium. Another very advanced at the trade.
Am I wrong?
Yikes, that's scary. How did you know that? How, you say?
The universal skeptic would say that how is nothing but a question of why.
I am a traveler of both time and space and a swimmer of dreams.
What is he talking about? I can't make heads or tails of it. I don't know.
Without further ado, let me fulfill what should be the first duty of any gentleman and introduce myself. The name is Atme. Luke Atme.
Is that seriously your name? Luke Atme? Luke Atme. That literally is dumb. That is worse than any miney.
Ace defective.
Hi.
Don't let him intimidate you, Nick. Stand up and show him what you're made of.
Yeah, I don't know. No, he definitely looks like the type to have a radio demon voice, so yeah, that's why I gave him that voice. But then you said his hair looks like a lightning bolt, then I thought of Kaminari. No, fuck it, he's Alistair and Kaminari mixed together. The name's Wright. Phoenix Wright. Ace Attorney. Oh,
no, wait! He said it! He said the thing! He said it! He said the thing!
Roll credits, the stream's over, he said it! The stream's over, he said the thing! Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney! Wait, I haven't found someone to raid. Okay, I'm just kidding. But, oh jeez, he said it!
I'm Earth-A, a spirit medium.
I'm Angel Membrane. Crappy streamer. And I'm,
yeah!
I don't know.
Pearl Fae.
I'm Mystic Maya's cousin and, Spirit Medium Ace Apprentice.
Excellent! Well then, shall we begin a little game?
When does the phrase one short of a baker's dozen come to mind with this guy? Wait, hold on. Hold on.
I got a game I want to show you. If I tell you my name, you'll have to play too. I've been here for years, biding my time, waiting in prime. Until I could find you, to sign on the line and we can be friends. I'll be here for you until your world ends. You dial your toys.
Alright, enough of that. Okay. Alright, joke's over. I'm not gonna play the whole song. Fun.
Hold on, I need to just get the rim shot ready. All right, that clip is ready. All right, let's continue on. All right. I don't want to get cut. Okay. All right, let's talk. So are you really as famous as you say?
Of course! For a lawyer, you have a rather shocking lack of knowledge about the world. I had no idea anyone was left in this city that had not heard of me. Look at me! I am Masked the Masked Arch Enemy! The Edge Detective, don't look at me!
I'm sorry.
At this moment, there are two mighty figures which loom large over this grand city. One embodies the nefarious forces of darkness, the other the angelic cherubs of light!
Tuxedo Mask? Oh, give me a break, he's not even here, soy sight.
He is Tuxedo Mask. I don't believe it.
Oh boy, now I'm really lost.
What is he saying, Nick?
I have been personally on the heels of this villain since his first crime. After learning this criminal's patterns, I thwarted his very latest loathsome larceny.
I hope that's how you said it. That's my first time seeing that word. Oh man, so many new words coming from this game, I don't understand.
I even returned the target of his tyranny, the portrait of Magina, to
the crime scene.
And I did it all by myself. I took it back from mask to mask with my brawny mind and my brawny muscles.
Yeah, they mentioned it on the news in the Great People Around Town segment.
They said that the museum gave you an incredible jewels reward.
Oh wait, I'm noticing something. The sword.
I'm distracted by background noise, it's a bit loud. Okay, well, compared to the treasure that I retrieved for them, it's not much.
So, in the end, the only thing that makes you great is your own self-praise.
Yeah, definitely, of course. And he seems so proud of it. Damn ego. Like, come on.
Oh, tell us what you know about Mask to Mask, and keep it simple, please.
Like about how I have devoted my life to thwarting his dastardly deeds. Last night, here in the bowels of this store, we were locked in the most glorious battle.
I see.
Huh? Hang on a second. You were here last night?
Here? In Lordy Taylor? Naturally. Wherever the mask goes, you will find at me laying his elegant traps.
Okay, it still feels so weird saying his name.
Elegant traps, more like the mask out elegance you and made a beautiful getaway.
Well, this time I allowed him to escape with the illusion of victory.
I wonder if I should ask him about what happened last night in more detail.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely, Rand.
I feel like I should have mentioned this earlier. This feels like maybe the first case. I know I shouldn't probably jump to conclusions, but I think this is like the first case that's not a murder case, you know? Like, no one has died yet. Like, someone just stole something. I mean, I don't know, there could be a murder later on, but right now there's no murder, so I might be speaking too soon, so I'm not 100% sure.
No, like, look, I'm just saying that every case in the first game was a murder case. Same with the second game. Every case was a murder case. But here it's not a murder case. Like, this is the first time.
Look, I'm just pointing that out, alright?
Whoa.
Why would you think I want someone to die so badly? What's wrong with you? Okay, back to the game. You don't know what to think of this Alistair wannabe?
Yeah, I don't know either.
I wonder if I should ask him about what happened last night in more detail.
The night of the crime. Can you tell us exactly what happened here last night?
But of course, after all, I always say there should be no secrets between aces.
Flattery will get you now. Flattery will get you nowhere, Pinocchio.
I first received...
Okay, he kind of does have a big nose. The case won't be so interesting if no... what do you mean? What would the real Angel Dust say in this case? I don't know. I don't know, but I think you probably suck his dick.
I first received the request for my services 20 days ago. And it was 10 days ago that we received Mask the Mask's calling card.
Huh? You were hired before the calling card even arrived?
Yes. You see, the person who hired me is quite rigorous and thorough.
That's Adrian for you.
A mere 10 days after hiring me, her worst premonitions were realized.
The calling card arrived, right?
Yes, so, ace detective that I am, I set a trap for the thief right in the warehouse, and waited for him. Alone.
Alone? But why? Why didn't you go to the police for help? Except, God does have a long nose. I was just about to mention that.
Ridiculous. Why would I seek help from such a singularly useless group of nincompoops?
Bro. You got a lot of nerve. After all, it was you that let the mask get away. Hell, I don't think even the real Alistair would... I really don't think the real Alistair would act like this. Alright, hold on. Oh, I'm trying to think of a description. Hold on. Alright, okay, the next spot should be exporting right now. Yeah, definitely not. Alistair have this big of an ego? No, I don't think so. After all, it was you that let the mask get away.
I always operate alone and concealed, out of the sight of others.
If he thinks, hey, yeah. Horn sealed.
Precisely. Even the gods on duty here were unaware of my presence. To fool your enemies, first you must fool your friends. It's my own original proverb.
Anyway, back to what happened last night.
As I was saying, I hid here in the White House and waited for the thief to arrive. But I sweaty... Is that pink blood?
That's... Okay. Okay, the whole murder case thing, I take it back. There's a murder case. Oh god.
But I swear to you, not a solitary soul came through that entrance. Nevertheless, the sacred end disappeared.
But that's impossible! How could it just disappear?
How, you ask? Don't be ridiculous, sir lawyer. If I knew the answer to that question, I wouldn't be here.
For someone who seriously messed up his own stakeout, he's rather full of himself. Oh, no, wait, it's pain. I see the buckets of pink labels in the background. So you're saying that even though on one came through those doors last night,
our precious urn still somehow vanished from under your nose?
That's just not possible.
Alright, time to examine the scene.
Sir Lawyer, please refrain from such crude behavior.
Huh? What do you mean?
This criminal is an artist. The crime scene is the canvas upon which he paints. Only I, Ace Detective Atme, have an eye which is educated enough to read the signs.
Could you translate that for me, Nick? I think he pretty much said, don't touch anything, amateurs.
If that's something you wish to know about, you have but to ask at me.
His name is so stupid.
I know everything there is to know about my rival Mask to Mask.
What do I do now? Does he have any top secret information? Stuff that only a real crime buff would know? I'll think about what to ask while listening to what Mr. Ace Defective has to say. Hold on, let me look at the core record. Alright, who's this dude? Alright, Face is 26, and Maya's 19, Pearl's 9. Yeah, everyone's, flashy thief who steals valuable works of art since calling card 4 heist. Age 34, an ace defective. I'm sorry, I keep saying defective, he looks like one. Has great powers of deduction, yet rarely makes sense.
Yeah, look for your headphones.
Yeah, okay, this is the thing I want to examine.
Said lawyer, please refrain from such oh my god, screw you!
Don't touch anything, amateur. What do I do now? Does he have any top secret information? Stuff that only the Ream crime buff would know? I'll think about that when I want to ask her. Well, anything to talk with him about? Do we have to present something to him? What about this calling card? What if he presented to him? Mask the Mask calling card. It's got his emblem printed on it, right?
Quite impressive! What I would expect nothing less from my arch rival!
I'm surprised to see you in possession of such a top secret piece of information! Well, we've got an ace lawyer, and an ace spirit medium, and an ace cousin apprentice here.
Yes, indeed. I think I could learn to like you, my fellow ace professionals.
I don't know if I really want this guy to like us. Ever.
Well, sir lawyer. I've been told that you two are pursuing the mysterious thief.
Well, I'm not sure, but
that's right!
Maya, I didn't get to read all that.
We're going to find the sacred urn no matter what we have to do. Excellent. I will trust you. I permit you to take a look around while I investigate elsewhere. If perchance you should discover something of value, return then to my office.
My Office of Earthly Delights, the Atme Detective Agency. Office of Earthly Delights?
Well then, Sir Lawyer, if you'll excuse me, I have much to do.
Wait a minute!
He's gone.
I don't like the idea of doing this guy's work for him.
Well, come on, Nick. Don't worry about it. It's no big deal. Let's hurry up and investigate before he changes his mind.
You're back, okay.
I want to go to his office, too. Take me with you, okay?
Alright.
That pathetic-looking wooden box. Ah! That's the box that had the sacred urn in it!
Don't touch it, there may be clues to the thief's identity on there.
I worked so hard to make that box.
Huh? You made that poor excuse for a box, Maya? What's that supposed to mean?
That urn has always been on its stand in the Winning Way of Fae Manor, so there was no box suitable for it, Mr. Nick. And, I was so proud of it.
Did Maya just foam at the mouth? I didn't see it. Oh, poor Maya. Maybe it'd have been better if Mask the Mask had taken the box too.
Wow, this is awesome. What did Miss Andrews say it was called again?
Shichishito. It has the word shit in it. It's literally seven branches short in Japanese. Or so says Miss Andrews.
Whoa. It's pretty heavy.
One hit seven times the fun.
Yeah, pretty catchy, huh? I bet it sounds like hotcakes.
Maya reminds you of Wednesday? I haven't seen Wednesday, so I don't know.
There's something about it that bothers me.
Wow, you're really firing all cylinders today, Pearly.
The sword, wasn't Mystic Gamey holding it last night? Now, another thing. The sword wasn't bent last night like it is now.
You're right.
Oh, awesome, Pearly. I wouldn't expect any less from my little ice apprentice.
Sword is bent, so that must mean last night someone used it somehow.
Aha! I just thought of something. Maybe Detective Atme smash mask the mask with it. Like this. Yeah! Oh, what the hell?
My god. Oh, what do you think, Pearly?
Why?
I think it's even more bent than it was before. Great job, you fucked with a crime scene.
Oh man, my head! My hair!
Oh god.
A ceremonial sword held in the hand of Amy Faye's statue wasn't bent before the crime. Alright, anyways, we come here to the pink blood. Look what you did, Nick. You spilled blood over here.
I didn't do that.
Well, it wasn't here last night. I would have noticed a color that's I would have noticed a color that's outrageous. But this paint has already dried up.
Well then, you should have cleaned it up before it dried, Nick. Blood doesn't dry that fast. Besides, I told you it wasn't me.
It looks like it's been several days since it was spilled.
Hey, look at this. What is it?
There's some kind of shape left in the bottom left side of the stain.
Huh? Oh, you're right. I wonder what it could be.
The statue of Mr. Gamey is so cool. I want to go to the statue of myself. We can put it in the office. Hey, it's Wright & Co. What about a gold statue of me?
Hey, well, it used to be Faye & Co., you know that?
Mr. Nick, I'm sorry, but I noticed something strange.
Huh? What is it, Pearls?
The statue of Mr. Gamey. Was this where it was last night?
I'm pretty sure it was closer to the door.
I think you're right.
No, great job, Pearly. I wouldn't expect anything less from my ex cousin.
The statue was moved on the night of the crime.
It looks like a part of a big signboard. All I can read on it is the burr.
Aha! I got it! Maybe it's supposed to say hamburger!
Why would anyone write hamburger that big?
Like, maybe for the World Hamburger Festival or something?
I kinda doubt it. Now I'm being reminded of, like, that big meatloaf festival from, like, Phineas and Ferb. I don't know.
Oh, I've got it! Maybe it said spaghetti!
Why are you talking about food? No, wait, that's normal for you. Yeah, she loves food.
Anyway, it says burr. There's no way it could be spaghetti. Well, maybe it was a typo. It might have said spaghetti festival. What do you think?
Okay to me. Besides, spaghetti is the only thing more tangled than your reasoning. What the hell is going on? There's a ladder around here. I want to examine it. It's a security camera. It's trained on the big door to the storeroom. It's set up to take a photo of anyone that goes in or out.
A security camera. Yeah, go stand in front of that door and it'll snap your photo too, Pearly. Mr. Kamaya, do you think I should smile? Nah, it's for criminals, so I think you should make a really scary face. Like this?
Oh boy.
Mr. Nick, what's that big door over there?
It looks like it's the door to the actual storeroom. I can see lots of big boxes and stuff back there.
I guess that's where they were keeping the sacred urn.
Remember, Maya, Miss Andrews said we're not allowed in there.
Okay, I think we examined everything we need to, so, and then, oh boy. Here we are. You're here? Cool. At me, detective agency. This is a detective agency? It looks more like the set of some B-grade horror movie. Hello? Is anyone here? Oh, God. It looks like nobody's home. Oh, what a waste of time. Oh, hey, I know. Let's take that framed picture back with us as a memento. And hopefully we won't get murdered by it. No, don't you dare, Maya! Guess we'll have to try back later. I guess we could examine everything while we're at it. This desk is literally covered with all sorts of chemistry equipment. Oh, I just love chemistry. Say, Nick, I bet you didn't know this, but, water is made up of carbon and hydrogen. No, not carbon, oxygen! Oxygen and hydrogen! Oh, well, there are always alternative theories, I guess. If by alternative theories you mean the ones you made up inside that head of yours. Bro, why you do my girl like that? Come on. Can you not? Please.
Can you not?
That's one impressive bookshelf filled with some very impressive books. My Life as an Ace Detective, Unabridged Edition, by Luke Gatme, Ace Detective. Hey, he's even got one of those ships in a bottle thingies. Ah, would you look at that? There's a little Luke Gatme doll at the helm, how cute. There's a microscope here too. I wonder if he was researching something. The glass slides have different names on them. This one says Atme virus. Reminds me of T virus, huh? This guy's just dying to make a name for himself, huh? It's getting kind of irritating, actually. What a creepy painting.
Buzzbo!
You're so bored. You want to join me on Discord? I'm in the voice chat right now. What a creepy painting. It's like he's looking right at me. Maybe we should put up a big portrait of you in the office, Nick. I can even paint it for you. Maybe you can pose while cleaning the toilet. I think I'd prefer something a bit more dignified. It's one of those old phonographs. Oh, hey, Nick, what's this thing here? It's called a gramophone. In the old days, people used them to listen to music. You can't be serious!
Bryn clipped out of the... And I wasn't there. Why'd it have to be this way?
You can't be serious! I think it's probably for purifying the air or something.
I'll bet you 50 cents. Come on, what do you say?
Forget it. You never pay up when you lose.
I never pay up when I lose.
Whoa, it's a huge hearth!
That's a fireplace.
So? What's the difference? You need to stop judging things based on narrow-minded cultural assumptions, Nick.
Right, sorry. Are we back to the whole ladder thing?
Wait, hold on. Something... What's with this big cushion? It's just lying around with nothing on it.
Well, it must be for the greatest treasure of all.
Greatest treasure? Is there something like that?
Huh? Why, well, of course there is. Right, Prelly? Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
I'll bet it would really take your breath away.
A piece of cloth with a ton of finely written characters jammed onto it. Probably esoteric knowledge. Only mediums would know. Esoteric, I've never heard that one before. Let's see.
Here's the title in English. 108 Ways to Save Money. I'm pretty sure the number... Oh, Cosmo. Cosmo. I'm pretty sure the number has gone up since the last time I saw it. Well, we're always looking for new ways, you know. Being a medium sounds like a rough way of life. Oh, Mystic Mile, look! I can't believe it! Ah, it's so cute! It's a little diorama crane village! Yeah, look at that. But somehow it seems to reek of dreariness. Oh, Mystic Mile, it's your house! It even says Fey Manor on it! Oh, yikes, you're right! Hey. I kinda wanna add the famous in front of it. Don't do it, Maya. They might get mad. Hey, say something Cosmo would say.
What?
Say something Cosmo would say. Come on, you can do it. What? I don't think... Are you... Your mic is a bit...
I...
Say it again.
I'm gay.
Thank you.
Okay,
They're just a bunch of old urns. Are these really treasures too?
Well, of course they are! This is a treasure exhibit.
Wait, are you being serious, Cosmo?
Yes, I'm being serious.
Okay, here he is. There's your question answered, Rin. Of course they are. This is a treasure exhibit, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I guess so. So all it takes to be a treasure is age? No wonder nobody likes museums.
Ouch.
I think I remember this old folding screen here. I'm pretty sure it was an important piece of evidence. In that murder case.
So I'm half gay.
Oh yeah. In that murder case that happened in Crane Village. This folding screen is the greatest of all the spirit channeling secrets. Turn it up a bit. Alright. Greatest of all of the spirit channeling secrets.
The six-leaf Karain Sacred Writings floating screen!
If it's so secret, why is it the most prominent thing in the exhibit? It's just laying out in the open. Alright, well, don't know where to go from here. Back to Rhett and Co. I don't know what's going on.
But did I tell you I started making music?
Oh, alright, you did, didn't you? Or... I don't know. Yes? No? I don't know.
I don't remember if I did. I think I did.
You think?
Maybe. Let me check the idea.
What do I do? Do I present the sword to him? What about this?
Sorry, pal. I didn't get much sleep last night and my brain's not really working right.
Somehow, I don't think sleep would really fix the problem.
Hey, keep it down. He might have really good hearing for all you know. He might get mad if he heard.
I can hear everything you are saying, pal.
Oh, I actually didn't tell you. Surprisingly.
No, you did not. That was Charlie.
But anyways, I'm like a singer.
Oh, I think you can change your server profile. Well, maybe if like you're on multiple servers, you can change your name. Well, only for that server.
Yeah, Yeah, you can do that.
Oh, wait. I thought Rin was talking about something else. Sorry. Should you put it as Charlie instead of Rin? I don't know. Your choice. If you really want
what
to,
what do you
then...
think she was talking about?
I thought she said that she should have instead of should I. Like, I read it wrong. Like, maybe I'm dyslexic and all.
Alright, back to the game.
Wait,
remember.
Rin has Discord?
Yeah.
Remember, don't tell anyone about that emblem, okay, pal?
Does the thief ever send these to the police?
No, always to the victims. Up until now, the victims have always come to us looking for help, though.
That's not what happened this time, you mean?
You got that right, pal. Listen up, if you guys ever get one of these calling cards, I want you to come to us right away. Got me?
Yeah, sure.
But
to be honest, pal.
Oh boy.
To be honest, pal, there's something that bugs me.
What's that?
All the other items that were stolen by Mask the Mask were ones even I heard of. They were all world famous treasures. The Tear of Eminon or the Crown of Bongora. The Sacred Ring of Karain is famous too, right, Prilly? Well, of course, everyone in Crane Village knows. Crane Village knows about it.
Sounds like we've got an unpredictable thief on our hands.
What about Co-seller? Hello, what's up?
Is this Naruto? What do you mean?
This isn't Naruto.
We stream same game. Ooh, very nice.
Who's Co-seller? Is he cool?
He's in the chat.
Whoa.
Switch chat, I mean. Yeah.
I don't know. He tries hard. But
yeah,
like...
I do.
What do I examine? Oh, the computer. Oh, I never examined the computer. Hey, Pearly, do you know what this is as a computer?
A computer? Oh, I've heard of those. It's such a cute name.
It looks like this computer is for storing the data from the security camera. When someone comes in or out of the warehouse, the camera takes a photo of them.
It's probably the trap that the detective set up. Let's see if we can find last night's data on this thing.
We might even... find a photo of Mask to Mask. Let's see here. Man, I really stink at working these things.
Oh, what's wrong, Mr. Nick? You're sweating an awful lot.
Okay. He does that a lot in court. I don't know how to pull up the photos.
I had no idea you were so pathetic with high-tech stuff, Nick.
He's too old. Yeah, well, I managed to print out the camera data anyway.
Oh, I guess you have to learn to crawl before you can walk, right, Nick?
Yeah, sure. Anyway, it looks like the camera only went off once last night.
Alright, the warehouse camera went off once at around 1 a.m. on the night of the crime. Okay.
Can we check it more? No. Alright. Well, I guess that covers everything. Oh.
Hey, Nick, your cell phone's ringing. Hello? Phoenix right here. It's me, Gumshoe. Gumshoe, what is it? What's so funny?
Oh, I'll tell you what's funny, pal. I finally beat him! I beat Mr. Ace Detective!
Finally, this underdog is the Alpha Dog today! That stuck up Detective's men is match! Yep, I finally caught up. Look, stuck a barrel. There's no escape for him!
You caught him? Are you saying...
You captured Mask to Mask? Bingo! Well, actually, he surrendered. But I still got him!
Mask to Mask surrendered?
Well, that's great. So when can we...
Yeah, I'd like to see one of your streams.
Alright, that's great. So when can we come pick up the Sacred Urn? Well, you see.
I was gonna tell you...
What? Something wrong?
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Do you think you can swing by the detention center sometime?
The detention center?
He wants to talk to you. Well, Mask to Mask, that is. What? He wants to talk to Nick? I'll be waiting for you, pal. So get over here soon.
The detention center, huh?
Off to the detention center we go.
I can't even remember the last time I streamed.
Yeah. Thank you for the kind words,
Priscilla. It was like 4 months ago, I think.
Oh, hold on, let me check.
Maybe I should, like, stream.
3 months ago.
Pricing. I think the last stream I did was, like, just Harvest Moon speedrun.
Harvest. Yeah. I did find some Harvest Moon, well, it was Story of Seasons, but whatever. I did find some Harvest Moon games, like, for free to download on PS Plus, and I found them for sale on the PlayStation Store. I thought about doing just chatting. I've been seeing friends and pioneers of town around recently. I'm thinking about those the most.
Pioneers of all of town is kind of shit, to be honest. Friends of Mineral Town is so much better. Friends of Mineral Town is older, like a lot older, but Pioneers of all of town is just, for some reason,
well,
all the Story of Seasons games have been getting worse over time.
Oh, but that's what you think.
Except for, like,
Except for Remix.
Like Story of Seasons, Friends of Mineral Town, and Wonderful Life.
Yeah, but... Well, hey, you recommended it to me. Well, Friends of Mineral Town, I mean.
Like, so I'm thinking about playing. Like, One World, Harvest Moon, One World, they're pretty bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, classics are pretty much the best.
Yeah. All right.
Back to the game. Oh, hey, pal. Welcome to the detention center.
You're sure in a happy mood, aren't you?
Yep. After all, we got Mask to Mask right. But, so where's the Sacred Urn?
Oh, sorry about that, pal. I guess I didn't really think about it before. But you're the victim in this case.
Wait, what?
Huh?
Well, I guess I should let you guys hear the story straight from the horse's mouth. You know, he's right, Nick.
He is? Yeah.
He is? If you think about it real hard, we are the victims!
Well, I guess so. In a way. I'm so used to thinking of the victim as a dead person because we're always on murder cases. Excuse me, who is this? But anyway, I have to get the Sacred Urn back.
Please, don't just ignore me!
Oh boy. Who are you? Oh yeah, I have done that. I have. Mask to Mask. Okay. Hey, Nick. Doesn't he look kind of, well, gangly?
I've heard that one before. I'm Ron Delight. I'm thinking that's a pun on something, I just don't know what. I'm Ron Delight, the famous masked mask. I don't think this guy could punch his way out of a wet paper bag. So, last survey I did was a couple of months ago. So, you're the Mask the Mask guy?
Yes, you bet!
No, that's wrong. Look, you see, it's complicated. Sort of yes and sort of no, if you know what I mean. The letters are fading out. Oh, that's new. What's wrong? I can hear myself. Well, when I say wrong... I can hear myself, Cosmo. Oh, yeah?
I don't even know what I'm doing.
No. You don't. Alright. Well, when I say wrong, what I really mean to say is that it's not right per se. You see, it's not spelled mask to mask, it's actually mask to mask. What's with this guy? Well, he's a timid little weakling, we know that much. Don't do that. Don't look at me like that! I don't need your pity! And I made you cry, baby, too. So, why did you give yourself up? Well, you see, it's because... Well... I know why! It's because you stole such a priceless treasure! And now you're overwhelmed with guilt. Am I right? Priceless treasure. Okay, see ya, Ko. Thank you for being here. Priceless treasure? That broken old urn? I have a little... Come back next stream? Okay, cool. I've seen you there. I have a little favor to ask. Yes? What is it? Could you go and talk to Desi? Desi? Look, we really want to earn back, so where is it? I'm sorry, I'll give it back. I really will. Maybe not. No, I can't. I can't make promises I can't keep. I'll just stand up. Mr. Nick? I couldn't hear what he just said. Well, especially that last part. Mr. Damask? Do you think you could speak up a little? Yes, sir. I will. I promise. Or maybe not. You see, I'm already speaking to my normal voice, so I can't really do anything.
If I enjoyed Danganronpa, do you think I'd enjoy Ace Attorney?
Well, if you're into murder mystery, then yeah, I'd say you would.
Danganronpa is fun.
Yeah, really.
Which games of Danganronpa have you played?
I've only played the first and the second one, that's it.
You should play V3 if you can somehow.
I sort of want to watch the end of Hope's Peak Academy first. Like, I want to watch that before I play V3, so yeah, we're going to hold off on that for a while.
But you're going to watch the anime?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mr. Damask, about the urn. Oh, yes, the urn, right away. Actually, no. What is display name? What do you mean? Hold on. Rondelite, 23 years old. I don't know. Bit of a pitiful guy. Actually, no. I wouldn't mind telling you.
I wouldn't mind telling you, but actually I'm afraid you wouldn't believe me anyway.
Enough already! Just tell it to us straight!
Please. Please. Please don't yell at me! I'm sorry. That urn, I
lost it! What?
Lost it?
What did you just say? You just say you lost it?
Yes, no, maybe so. I mean, yes, I lost it!
What do you mean?
Well, you know, I lost it. Like I said, these things just happen. You're on the train and you get distracted and you forget your bag, you know?
What? You forgot our sacred urn on a train? Wait a minute. You went on the train dressed like that?
No, I was just speaking hypothetically, that's all. Anyway, I'm sorry! I just lost it somewhere, I don't know where!
This guy's story is more surreal than a Dali painting. Are you really sure this creep is masked a mask? Maya, don't call him a creep.
Although I do have to admit, I understand your doubts about this guy. So, who is this Desi person?
Please, don't talk about my wife like that!
I guess she must be his wife.
I'm sorry. The truth is...
It was my wife that told me to have you all come here.
Do you think you can go and visit her at my hideout?
Hideout?
Mr. Nick, what does she mean by hideout? Did you... Oh, not yet.
Okay, now I see it.
Send your friend request. Charlie... Oh, maybe I got the wrong name. Huh? Well, can you try sending me the name again?
Mr. Nick, what does she mean by hideout?
Oh, sorry. Naturally, I meant to say my secret base.
Secret base?
Well, my apartment, actually. Palazzo Pel Pepe, third floor. Let's go have a look, Mick. It's a mask-to-mask hideout.
Something tells me she just likes the sound of the word hideout.
Eh? Oh boy.
Wow, check this place out.
Can I post something?
Okay.
No doubt about it, this is mask-to-mask hideout, alright.
This is mask-to-mask hideout, alright.
Who is it? Is that you, Ronnie?
Oh.
Huh? Who are you people?
Are you Desi Delight?
That's right, I'm Desiree.
Ah!
Oh. You must be the lawyer and the victim.
Yeah, that's us. Your husband told us to stop by and speak with you.
Oh, I'm Maya Faye. And this is Phoenix Wright, attorney at law.
Nikki Boy and Maya, huh?
I can't tell you how grateful I am that you decided to help my Ronnie.
Well, you're welcome.
Did she really call me Nikki Boy?
About your husband.
Isn't he the cutest? Well, a bit weak sometimes, though.
A bit?
By the way, did you know they mentioned Maya on TV?
Huh? Really?
They said you only earn and that you're doing some shady training at a law office now.
Remind me what not to watch that channel's news program. Yeah, I don't watch the news at all. I never.
After I saw that, I thought it might be a good idea to meet the lawyer they mentioned.
I see.
My Ronnie. He has a powerful imagination and gets deluded easily. He kept insisting that he was going to surrender to the police. I didn't know what to do.
It was me! I stole that urn, he kept saying.
It was as if it was even possible.
Huh? But... Are you saying he didn't?
Well, of course he didn't. Why would my Ronnie ever do something like that?
Well, you know, it's a priceless treasure, and he's...
Well, you know...
Is it possible his own wife doesn't know his secret identity? Oh my god. She don't know? She don't know?
Me, I'm the kind of woman that needs excitement in her life.
Oh, excitement, huh?
Yes, I'm at my happiest when I'm racing alone with my bike going at full throttle. Granted, motorcycle is like putting your life on the line, you know what I mean?
Well, I think that depends on how you ride it. Ain't that the plot for Kamen Rider?
I'm the type that can't stand living a boring, dreary old life with no action.
No offense, but your husband Ron doesn't exactly look like the risk-taking type himself.
Well, you're right about that. He's definitely not one for thrills and danger.
Back? Alright, cool. Where'd you go?
I was just mixing a song real quick.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Alright. But I do have to say that he makes up for it in other ways.
Other ways?
Well, yes, money. Ronnie is incredibly rich and super generous. He bought me a bike that's so fast it will make your head spin. And shopping? Well, I like to shop so much it makes Ron's head spin. The other day it actually happened. His head actually started to spin.
Oh man, talk about a high-maintenance wife. Talk about the Exorcist.
So where does Mr. Delight get all this money from? Ronnie is a security guard. They put their lives on the line, right? So they get paid tons of money in return, tons of it.
He's a security guard? I think it's my turn for my head to spin. Yeah.
Can you tell us about what happened last night? What time did that incident take place again? What time was it again, Maya?
Well, according to Detective Gumshoe, it was around 1:30 in the morning.
Ah, last night was horrible. I got pulled over.
Hold over.
Yes. I always do my best flying at night.
Yahoo.
Maybe I should send you the friend request now? It's not working. Well, the friend request. Send it to me again.
Send a photo of it to me.
Just DM it to me, Ren.
Yes, I always do my best flying at night.
Flying? You're talking about your motorcycle, right?
Well, yes. Anyway, last night I got pulled over by a policeman. I can't believe he caught up to me. That was a great chase, let me tell you. When he finally caught me, the poor man was as white as a sheet. It was about 3 in the morning when I finally got home.
Sounds like she's got an airtight alibi.
Well, what about Mr. Delight? I don't really know. We weren't together at that time of the night, but when I got home, he was already fast asleep.
So basically, he's got no alibi. Time to examine Gerald. That looks like a big dildo.
Oh, Nick, it's a dildo. I mean, it's a torpedo.
It's hard to believe, but it sure looks real.
Bro, are you not watching the stream? Look at it.
I'm not watching. Should I? I just don't want to spoil myself, but okay. Where?
It's on the right. It's hard to believe, but it sure looks real. Where could he have picked up something like this?
It looks like a torpedo. I don't know what you're talking about.
Please don't say that. Torpedoes are things people just leave lying around. Looks like I failed triple N. It's mask to mask. There's a tape recorder hanging from his neck. Oh, let me see that. I'll be taking this crown now. Better luck next time, gentlemen. I don't get it. What's this supposed to be, Nick? Can you give me a second? I gotta see what's... Alright. I'm gonna mute myself really quick and I'll be right back. Alright. Alright, and some background noise can be really loud, and it pisses me off.
I'm not here.
Yeah, anyways. Fun, let me try the display, let me try the actual username. Alright, Ren, I sent it,
not working for me, I said.
This thing looks vaguely familiar. Oh, I know, it's a fishbowl. Well, an upside down one anyway. I think it's a helmet, an alien helmet. And that looks like a tape recorder or something next to it. I think it's a transceiver, an alien transceiver. Nick, do you think maybe you could act like a grown-up for a little bit?
Getting lectured by Maya to be more of an adult, that's a new low. Oh, you shut up, Nick.
Name is Ren, but it wasn't working, though. Oh, that's so cute. It's called a hot air balloon, you know? Wow, there's no fooling you. I want to make my own balloon now. I'll even let you ride in it, Nick. That emblem on the balloon is supposed to be top secret. That's proof enough that Rhonda Light really is mask to mask. I better not tell Maya. She gets kind of Gary when it comes to celebrities. Yeah, definitely. No, especially the Steel Samurai. There's a whole bunch of stuff piled up over here.
Oh, taking cover! It's a missile! Did you know there's dynamite and missiles?
But they're not heavy enough to be real. No, wait, they're just really well-made toys. What are these rolls of paper stuck in the trash can? Theft of the Mazarin Stone, the Great Albatross Strategy. Theft of the Immortal Goddess Statue, the Great Knuckle Bomber Strategy. Did the police even investigate this place? Yeah, wait, what about these books? There are a bunch of books lying here.
They're all romantic sounding novels about famous heists and fantastic thieves.
Wow, look at all the bookmarks and notes stuck into them.
Let's see here. No, must remember the thief's way of laughing, very useful. No, the calling card is an important part of any good thief's modus operandi. Oh, wow, Ron really studied this stuff. And, nothing left to- Oh, guns! Wait, we can't examine those either. What about these drawers? Oh my god, dynamite sticks. Oh boy. Oh wait, we can examine this too. Oh hey, Nick, look on top of the chair. Looks like an envelope and a letter.
Well, don't just stand there. Come on, let's read it.
Maya, you know we shouldn't do that.
What are you talking about? That letter could be an important clue.
No way. You can't just go read a private letter because you feel like it.
Huh. It's not just because I feel like it. It really could be important.
If I was sure it was a clue, I guess I wouldn't mind. Man.
Okay, what if we present this?
What if?
So what do you know about this? No, you can't show her that, Nick! That emblem is top secret, don't you remember? No, sorry about that.
But the way she just said top secret was a worse giveaway than what I did.
Oh, when I hear the word top secret, it just piques my interest like nothing else.
Well, great, now she's interested about it. No, we're not gonna tell her, though.
Yeah, we met this dude, and we met his wife.
We went to his apartment thing.
Oh wait, hold on. Mr. Light, you must know, right? About your husband and Mask the Mask.
Mask the Mask? Oh, of course, I know all about it.
My husband is his biggest fan.
His...
Yep, what? Huh? The biggest fan? Yes, and Ronnie can be pretty delusional sometimes. Well, that's how this whole misunderstanding happened. Wait a minute! Did you say delusional?
Yes, that's right. I just don't know what I'm gonna do with him.
You see, Ronnie actually believes that he is Mask the Mask.
What? Oh. Oren says she added you, Cosmo.
What are you talking about?
So, when did Ron first become Mask the Mask?
What are you talking about? He's not Mask the Mask!
Huh?
But wait a second! Look around this room! This place is obviously Mask the Mask hideout!
No, you're totally wrong. A real thief's hideout wouldn't look like this!
It's because Ronnie is so timid himself that he looks up to heroic figures.
Heroic figures? But Mask the Mask is a bad guy. So he's deluding, huh? Could that really be true?
Anyway, if you really had stolen the urn, wouldn't you still have it?
Well, I suppose so.
Then why don't you ask him if he has the urn or not?
She has a point. Mr. Delight isn't that exactly the criminal type. But something about Ron's behavior bothers me.
Maybe it's true. Maybe Mr. Delight isn't Mask the Mask after all.
Say, can I ask you something, Nicky boy?
What is it?
I know I may seem like a bad girl on the outside, but the one thing I won't stand for is illegal activity.
I had the feeling you wouldn't. You're tough, but I can tell you've got a good heart.
Somebody framed my poor Ronnie, I just know it. Could you give this to Ronnie for me?
A letter?
Yes, for Ronnie. I want him to fight back. Miss Delight.
Okay, you've got it. Just relax and leave it all to us.
Addressed to her husband, Ron Delight. Apparently contains something important.
Alright, now we can go back to the detention center, and we can present the thing to him.
Oh, that's
Rin
right.
Should join
should she?
Hey, Rin,
yeah,
come join
that
us.
That would be fine.
Nice profile pic. Very
but
nice.
She wants to.
Oh, that's right. Here.
I swear, if I'm getting another blood house, then I'm gonna.
What you playing?
What?
If you get another bloody mouse, what you playing?
I said, if I get another bloody nose.
Oh.
This is like my fourth one today.
Oh, Jesus.
I think I need to get my nose checked.
Oh, jeez, are you alright, dude?
Hopefully.
Dude, please, I'm concerned. Please take care of yourself.
Oh my gosh.
Great, Noah. I don't know.
Let me go get a paper towel or something.
Yeah, please, please. Alright.
Oh, that's right.
Hold on.
Here, this is from your wife. Oh, from Desi? Thank you!
Do I think about something?
What? No, I... What?
Rin. I don't know. Letter given a mask to mask? Actually, more like taken.
My dear Ronnie, how are you?
I'm doing fine.
He's clutching onto that letter so hard, the ink is gonna be squeezed out. Never heard that one before.
He looks so happy. You should write a letter to Mystic Maya too, Mr. Nick.
I think I'm good.
You think? Alright. Alright. Yeah, please be alright.
Oh, Ron. Mr. Lawyer?
Yes?
In the letter that Desi wrote, she said, ask this guy to be your lawyer.
Huh?
I know this will be asking a lot, but would you please take my case? My trial starts tomorrow.
Hey, hang on a second. What? He can't be your lawyer.
Well, why not?
I don't even know what Rick's talking about.
Oh my god, where do I start? You asked her to come join the streaming VC. Then, she was like, I think she's refusing to.
Yeah, but what about, you think about something dirty? What does that even mean?
I don't know, I...
No one mentioned anything.
How'd you even get to that conclusion?
Rin.
What do you mean?
And, oh my gosh.
An anime reference, of course.
My nose.
Dude, please take care of yourself. I am concerned.
A bunch of blood is coming from it.
Oh, jeez, dude.
So much. Just like earlier.
Dude, please take care of yourself. Please.
If I pass out on this call, you'll know the reason.
Oh, God.
Anime reference.
Hey. I don't even know where that's from. Whatever anime you're talking about. All right.
What do you mean, why not?
No combo.
We're the victims in this case, right? Victims of the mask guy.
Well, yeah, but according to Desiree, he didn't do it.
She said, poor man, he's deluded himself into thinking he did it. Right, Mr. Nick?
Come on, she should be lying to... She could be lying to protect her husband.
Oh, well, that's true.
I know it's true.
No, actually not.
Actually, it's hard to say.
Oh no, it's spreading! No, please, I'll give you the treasure.
I'm so concerned about you. I'm so very concerned.
Oh, please, I'll give you the treasure of your choice in return.
What should I do?
We're taking his case, of course!
Well, Mr. Delight, I have decided to give it a try. I'll defend you.
Really? You will? Hey, what are you doing, Nick? He's a thief! You can't trust him!
Well, he may be a thief, but I think there's more to this case than meets the eye.
Mr. Nick, I was wrong about you. I shouldn't have trusted you!
Pearls? I can't believe you defend this person after what he did to Mystic Maya.
I'll never forgive you. Ever.
This doesn't feel right. This definitely don't feel right.
Pearly, wait!
Oh, this is gonna be ugly.
I'll go after
her. So it's come to this. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to cause any trouble. Well, you couldn't have known she'd react like that. I guess I might as well start investigating. Oh, Maya, where's Pearls? She said she's going back to the office. Go check in on her later, would you? And what about you? Are you okay with me taking Mr. Delight's case?
Yeah. I'm fine, Nick. I believe in you.
I think I'm gonna cry. Next door neighbor, please don't. I know you have a lot of work to do. I really appreciate it.
Okay, Nick, let's get this show on the road!
Hold on. This guard monitors the visitor's room. It looks like he doesn't have much to do right now. I can tell because he's looking at the camera and making funny faces. So now the guard's actually doing stuff? Like in the other games, he wasn't doing anything.
Smile, you're on candid camera.
Remember that show? The camera doesn't seem to have a lot of tape right now. The only thing it's watching now is that guard over there.
Wow, my nose. It hurts.
Dude, please take care of yourself.
In what way?
I
don't want to lay down because the blood's going to go in my throat.
Hey.
My nose actually hurts, though.
Did you try pinching your nose?
Then I have to, like, breathe from my mouth.
Yes.
My sister, when she studied, health, she said the best way, the fastest way to stop a nosebleed is to, like, go somewhere where it doesn't matter and just, like, hold, like, the bone, like, the top of your nose until it stops bleeding.
Well, how about you try that?
I can't go, like, outside right now, but maybe, like, I could, like, hold my nose, like, in front of my sink or something.
You could. All right.
I don't think it's bleeding anymore. Hopefully not. It still hurts a little though.
Alright. Back to the game.
Oh, Mr. Nick! Welcome back!
Oh, hey, Pearls. Oh, you're back too, I see. Look at your profile? Okay.
Okay, maybe I gotta maybe I gotta reload Discord.
I looked at her profile, it's just blank.
Yeah, it's still the... I don't know.
No, hey, Pearls. You're back too, I see.
I went and bought us a strawberry cake. I'll go make some tea to go with it.
Hey, Pearls. It looks like she feels really bad about what happened at the detention center.
Mr. Nick, I was wrong about you. I shouldn't have trusted you. I'll never forgive you.
Nauseous. Oh god.
I think I'm losing blood fast.
Oh, jeez.
Maybe I should tell my parents.
Yeah, maybe, you should.
Also, Randy, your profile is blank.
Mystic Maya, the tea is ready. Oh, thanks. Come on, Mr. Nick, please have some of this cake.
I like cake.
Yeah, thanks. Pearls? Oh, excuse me, I was in the middle of cleaning the toilet.
Bro.
Hey, it's okay, I just cleaned it this morning.
Too late. This might be a good time for me to ask about her. I first met Pearls a year ago. It was when that murder happened at Karain Village. I still remember what she said to me when we first met.
You're Mr. Nick, right? You're Mystic Maya's special someone.
Hey, Maya, I've always thought it was because she was young, but what? Pearls, I think she's got the wrong idea about you and me.
There's something you need to understand.
Well, what is it?
It's kind of like a Korean village custom, sort of.
Pearl seems to love you a lot.
Well, it's because I'm her only cousin, and, well, because of the murder case last year, Pearlie's mother is...
Oh, yeah. I remember now. Pearl's mother, Morgan Fay. She's serving a prison term in isolation right now.
Oh, I thought she was dead.
So you see, I'm the only family Pearlie has right now. But it's the same for me too. My mother's gone too. There are hardly any men in Crane Village.
Now that you mention it, I never actually saw any men there when I visited.
I'm pretty sure I told you about it a long time ago. About how spiritual powers run very strong in the Fae family.
Yeah, you did. And that's why you're undergoing training to be a spirit medium, right?
Yeah, the thing is, only women can actually inherit the spiritual power. That's why the whole culture of Karain Village actually revolves around its women.
Well, that's understandable. Well, nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, but because of that...
There tends to be a lot of unsuccessful marriages.
Oh?
Well, men start to feel left out after a while, and then they just start leaving. Especially if the man has a daughter. Are you saying that Pearl's father? He's gone. He left the village when she was very young. Oh boy, that's tough. Yeah, and she grew up seeing nothing but unhappy marriages all around her. That's why she's so sensitive to things like that. So your mother's still missing? Yeah. And no one has any idea where she is.
Maya's mother, Misty Fay. The current master of the Crane Challenge Technique. She disappeared 17 years ago after getting involved in a certain police case.
But you're sure she's still alive, right? Yeah, I know she is. It's sort of a spirit medium thing.
And if your mother doesn't come back, then what?
Then according to the laws of the village, I'll become the next master. Yeah, Cosmo?
Rin... It says Rin created her account in 2022. Of January.
Oh, that must have been, Let me see.
It does.
For the laws of the village, I'll become the next master. Your Honor. No. Well, she's on Discord, and that's that. Let's not fret about it. Mystic Maya, the master of the Karain technique. Sounds like heavy responsibility. Yeah, but there's no one else with the blood of the Fae main family who's a spirit medium. Your battery percentage. What do you mean messed up? It's not messed up at all!
69 is my favorite number.
Well, Nick, why don't we go and start investigating? We're not going to learn anything just sitting around the office. Yeah, I know, but... First, I want to talk to Pearls. Mr. Nick? Yeah, I know what's up.
I
thought about another sex number. It's called a 72. You don't know what a 72 is, don't you? Well,
72.
Yeah, 72 basically.
It's an angelic number, dude.
A 72 basically works like a 69, but you have like three fingers up the butt, so. Yeah, that's a 72.
You know the best number?
No.
420.
Oh boy. What is it?
It's my favorite thing, dude.
Mr. Nick?
Yeah?
I acted like a baby.
Pearls.
I doubted you. Even though Mystic Maya trusted you completely. I guess I still have a lot of training to do. Mr. Nick!
Yes?
From the bottom of my heart, I apologize for what I said. That's okay. I'm the one that should be apologizing. Well, I'm going out now for a little bit.
Huh?
Where are you going? I may be small, but I still have a lot of spirit channeling power. So I'm going to show you I can be useful, too. By finding some evidence!
Oh, boy.
Hey, wait a... She sure runs fast. Nick, let's back off and give her some room, okay?
Rin's not responding to me.
Rin.
Rin!
No, she probably went after the detective. Nope. I guess not. Where did she go? She went here. She went to the museum.
Maya! Oh, Miss Andrews. I'm so sorry. It's my fault. Your precious urn.
Well, she has more energy than she did before.
No, please, calm down. What's wrong? This never ends. Everything I touch ends in failure. Maya, I'm sorry. I'll do anything to make it up to you. Dude, I didn't have enough time to read that. Come on. I know I don't look it, but I'm good with my hands. I can make you another urn. Hold on. Just wait, okay? Breathe, calm down, and talk to us. Forgive me. Forgive me. Alright, let's talk.
She texted me. She said, you'll get this. You'll get this.
Yeah.
YLGITTHIS. I don't know what that means.
Where have I heard that before?
So when did you get the calling card from Mask to Mask?
Let's see, well, exactly 10 days ago. I was going to show it to the police, but that detective stopped me. So he asked Detective Atme to help with security?
Yes, in fact, it was about 20 days ago that I hired him. He seemed to know much more about that Mask to Mask than the police.
So you hired him for security even before the calling card arrived?
Well, yes, I had a premonition that something bad might happen.
I've learned to trust my hunches!
So that's why there are security cameras, even in the basement warehouse?
Yes, Lord Lee Taylor is very serious about their security measures.
It was their way of saying, bring it on, to any potential thieves.
Well, he sure brought it last night, and even left with a nice souvenir.
See if it's better on your phone? Okay.
Can you tell us a bit about the security for the treasure exhibit?
It was all my fault! I never should have called this paltry little collection a treasure exhibit anyway!
Why do you say that? The urn that was stolen is a pretty important object.
Maybe, but its actual value after appraisal was, well, practically zero.
Zero?!
I polished it until it was just about glowing. I thought maybe I could make it look more valuable! But that urn contains the soul of Mystic Amy. Anyway, I left all the security arrangements with Detective Atme. But 5 days ago, I began receiving all sorts of other exhibit items from Karain. Lots of people started going in and out of the warehouse down there.
So maybe one of them was actually Masked to Mask in disguise!
No, I personally checked out everyone that came through here, so that's not possible. Knowing Adrian, she probably even checked out what they ate for breakfast that morning. Okay, where could Pearl be? She has to... No.
Miss Andrews?
I know, it's all my fault! But what's done is done! I'll make it up by making a new one for you!
I'm just wasting my time, she's too far gone. Jesus.
Okay.
Okay, this music is good, I'll have to admit.
Oh, wait, hold up!
Hold up, wait a minute.
Hello?
Well, well. Blah, blah. How lovely it is to see you again, my dear. Welcome to my abode. Relax and soak up the atmosphere.
We're actually kind of...
What do you mean, Kane? Oh, wait. Kane? Who's Kane? Oh, God. Kane.
Hopefully not.
We're actually kind of...
Silence! Precisely as I expected.
What is...
Zavari! Truth has once again been elegantly revealed to me. Who the fuck is Zavari? A lawyer and a spirit medium. Am I correct?
I think we've already been through this.
Ha! So my estimation was correct! Zavari! Who the hell is that? How truly elegant. Now then, what can I do for you?
You mentioned before that you were on guard duty all alone last night.
Precisely. This is my fifth encounter with my arch enemy. I refuse to allow anyone to interfere with the rightful pursuit of my prey.
I heard you've been after Master Mess since his very first theft.
Yes, my dear, I've seen you've done your homework. In his very first heist, that vile thief pilfered the famous jewel, the Tear of Emanon. I first encountered him in the Museum Sacred Hall, the crime scene itself.
So that's why you were hired as security for the treasure exhibit? I'm pretty sure he said that Adrian Andrews hired him.
Yes, I borrowed some equipment from Lordly Taylor and set up the perfect trap.
You must mean the security camera. But I thought you were watching the area yourself too.
No, how could he be a human version of Alistair? He must worse than Alistair.
Does Alistair have this big of an ego? So how did the mask manage to steal the urn?
You think so.
How did Mask the Mask manage to steal the urn?
That's the million-dollar question. What is the mask's modus operandi?
Mr. Atme? Did you know about the sacred urn?
I am interested in only one thing, my dear, and that is Mask the Mask.
Sacred urn? That has nothing to do with this case.
But wasn't that what Mask the Mask stole this time? I'm not comfortable saying that.
I am a hunter, sir. The urn was nothing more than a lure to catch my prey. Do you yourselves remember the shape of the individual peanuts you throw to pigeons?
I don't think I like this guy's attitude, Nick. Well, anyway, it looks like he doesn't know about the urn. The mask is a hearty hold, yeah. Yeah, definitely. Something's vibrating. There's something that's kind of bothering me.
Please, my dear, ask me anything you like. After all, we are all but seekers wandering alone in the dark.
Well, I was wondering how Mask the Mask managed to, steal the urn.
I mean, isn't it strange that you don't seem to know?
Yeah, now that you mention it, it is strange. After all, you were on guard that night at the scene of the crime. Unless you were sound asleep, you should have at least seen Mask the Mask.
Oh boy, here it goes again.
One Cycloc.
What? It's a Cycloc. Cycloc?
Hey Nick, what is this Cycloc thing?
Well, your Magatama lets me see when people are keeping secrets. By breaking their mental locks, I can find out what those secrets are.
What? This Magatama has that kind of power?
Maya, you're the one who gave me this Magatama last year. Well, it's true that this Magatama is a prized Fae family heirloom, but Pearly was the one that actually imbued it with spiritual powers, right? That's why I don't really know much about what it can do. Wait, Cycloc or Magatama? I don't know. Wait, tell my Ren. Don't know much about what I can do. This is the woman that's gonna take over the Korean channeling school someday. Yep, Cycloc.
So how do you do it?
How do you break the Cycloc thing?
Well, you present the Magatama to the person with the secret.
Oh, cool, I can't wait to see it in action. Come on, try it out. Oh boy, I think the future master still needs to learn how to be patient. Alright. Let's try and go off what we have now.
Take that!
Alright, just one sec, Locke.
Mask to mask, Simo. Detective Atme, you were standing guard at the scene of the crime. There's no way you didn't see Mask to Mask commit the crime.
Well, now I can hardly see why you're so positive about that. Yes, indeed, I was guarding the White House, that much is true. But I can tell you for certain that not a single person passed through that door.
I'm not sure why, but Sammy Guy is lying through his teeth.
I know. I'll show him some proof.
Detective Atme, I have your proof that someone went through that door last night. Yep.
What Super Mario film?
She thinks Psylocke sounds like the name of a Super Mario villain. Psylocke. I don't know. There was a security camera set up at the scene of the crime. It should have automatically taken a photo of anyone that went through that door.
Precisely.
I hope you don't mind, but we've already gotten our hands on the camera data.
As you can see, the camera went off exactly once last night.
What?
But my monocle didn't catch anyone in its flash! It must be some kind of computer malfunction. It must be!
Maybe it was your monocle that malfunctioned.
What? Are you saying that I didn't do my duty properly?
Detective Atme, you must have seen the thief last night. The question is, why are you trying to hide it?
If he's hiding it, there must be some reason. Some reason that he desperately wants to keep hidden. And I've got just a piece of evidence that should prove it.
Okay, let's see you didn't manage to see Mask to Mask. In that case, the reason you didn't at that time was because you were...
using the bathroom?
I think he saw it.
Time to put your money where your mouth is. Show me your evidence. Wait, hold on, I got it wrong. Try it again.
Time to put your money where your mouth is.
What are you saying? He must have...
You were unconscious.
I'm afraid that making a guess is not enough. Time to put your money where your mouth is. Oh god. Show me your evidence!
Detective Atme, you were knocked unconscious by the thief, weren't you?
I sure you must be joking.
I am not joking, and don't call me Shirley.
You think that I, Luke Atme, could be knocked unconscious so easily?
This sword proves it.
That's... Before the theft, the sword was in the hand of the statue of Amy Faye. Furthermore, at that time, it was not bent. There's only one explanation. You were struck on the head and knocked unconscious by the sword.
Well, detective, how about it?
Well, I'm impressed. You truly are an ace attorney.
Oh, roll the credits, he said it. He said the thing.
I can't deny that there may be a small hint of truth in what you say. So, you were knocked out when the thief first clobbered you?
Clubber. What an ugly way of saying it. But I suppose you could put it that way.
The coward struck at the precise moment that I turned to look at the computer.
So you never noticed that the thief had entered the warehouse?
No. The coward must have wormed his way in through somewhere besides the door.
Your phone keeps vibrating. Cosmo.
Perhaps the air ducts or the sewer pipes. Then my arch nemesis struck me on the head from behind with this gruesome item here. Ouch, Mr. Amy should have his poor head examined.
You can say that again. How could he have underestimated the thief that badly?
Damask knocked Amy out during a crime with a blow to the back of the head.
Well, it looks like we got one thing cleared up anyway.
Huh? What? That Atme is the greatest ace detective in the world?
No!
No, that he never actually saw the thief.
Oh.
That's right. So the thief may not even be Masked Damask. Just one moment, sir lawyer! The thief was unquestionably Masked Damask! But you never actually saw him!
Perhaps so, but I installed a security camera just for such a contingency.
Oh. Last night, the camera went off exactly once. Behold! This is a photo of the dastardly thief taken by the security camera!
Oh my god.
That's him!
Masked Damask! Photo of storeroom entrance taken by the camera on the night of the crime.
The thief can be none other than the arch criminal. Masked Damask. After all, he has a very good reason for committing such brazen crimes.
What are you talking about?
So, what did you mean by he had a very good reason?
Exactly that. Mr. Delight had a very good reason to dress up and commit those crimes.
There should be a green envelope somewhere in his room.
Huh?
I think I'm gonna go to sleep.
No, are you? No, okay. Well, thank you for being here.
Good night, Angel.
Yeah, good night to you.
Yeah, I'll come back if I wake back up.
Alrighty. Go.
You'll need to go investigate.
But how would you know about that?
Have you forgotten? You're speaking to the finest ace detective to ever walk on the face of the earth!
Is your name Naruto Shiragane? You think you're Naruto Shiragane?
No, no way in hell. The most brilliant mind since, well, ever look at me!
Well, I guess we better go take a look, just in case.
Hey, Nick, remember what Detective Atme said? Exactly that. Mr. Delight had a very good reason to equip these guys with a green envelope somewhere in his room. You need to go investigate.
A green envelope, huh? Looks like this is it.
Okay, let's have a look.
If you don't want your true identity revealed to the world, come to KB Security at 1 a.m. on October 12th and bring
$50,000. $50,000?!
This is a blackmail letter!
Sure looks like a major clue, alright!
Written with a fountain pen found in Ron's room.
Ding dong? Oh, someone's at the door! I'll be right back. Won't take about a second, I promise.
Oh, thank you for coming. That's so nice of you. When I see a damsel in distress, I just can't help myself.
Please, come on in. I'll make some coffee.
Oh, really? Okay, I guess I'll make myself at home, pretty lady.
Wait a minute. I know that voice.
Oh, Nicky boy. I'm so sorry, but I got another guest.
Who is this? Wah! You're...
The... Larry! Nick, it's you! Maya too, what a fluke! Larry!
Long time no see.
What? You know each other?
Nicky boy!
Nick! Do you want this girl, you know, something going on?
Something? If you mute, I think I underestimated you, Nick! A gorgeous lady like this? And married too? Oh, way to go, dude!
I knew it.
Just when things can't get any worse, it's time to cue in the Butts. Larry Butts. Ever since grade school, he's been... not exactly a close friend, but yeah, we know each other.
Hey man, that wasn't nice! That was your first client!
We've got quite the storied history, he and I.
And what we used to say still rings true. When something smells, it's usually the Butts. Hey, come on now, you're embarrassing me! And in front of this pretty little thing here.
So you two are old childhood friends, I see.
Well, that's so sweet. You two go ahead and catch up on old times. I'm gonna go check out my bike.
Nice girl, that Desi.
So how have you been, Nick?
Too busy, if you really want to know. So, what have you been up to this whole time? It's been 2 years since I heard from you. And what's with those clothes? You look, well, weird.
Hey man, that's uncalled for! This is my uniform for my part-time job!
But I can't believe it's been 2 years. They say time flies when you're having fun. What's wrong?
Nick, I gotta tell you. Women. I don't trust them anymore.
You got dumped again.
Well, you know Bennifer?
I followed her all the way to Japan 2 years ago.
What kind of a name is Bennifer?
That's where I met the famous Caddy Tom and my whole life changed.
Bennifer?
Caddy Tom? I've never heard of either of them.
Anyway, dude, Caddy Tom chose Hollywood over me! Can you believe it?
Well, actually, anyways, sounds like you had quite the adventure.
Women! They're so, so...
Oh, but you're different, Maya. You're not like the rest. Looks like he's still the same old Larry. Why are you here? So, what are you doing here anyway? Huh?
What do you mean by that? I'm just a natural-born nice guy, that's all. Well, actually, I picked this up last night while I was working.
A wallet? You say you found this last night?
Yeah, it had a driver's license in it, so I figured I'd just return it myself.
Oh, Ron's wallet. Found by Larry as part-time security job. Security jobs company building, that crime. Hang on, let me see that for a minute. I knew it. Desi's picture is in here.
Yeah, I guess he really digs his wife, huh? Hey, Nick! It's not what you're thinking at all!
No, I'm pretty sure it is. You haven't changed a bit.
Aw, no way, man. I mean, she's a married woman. Well, that's just bad news.
He really is here just to check out Mr. Light. So, you said you found it at your job, right?
Yeah, I'm working for a private security company as a guard. Just this little guy in uniform, you know?
Is that really all you're doing? A security guard, huh? So that's what that uniform is all about.
Wallet.
So what time was it when you found this last night?
Huh? Why are you asking that? Trying to see if I've got an alibi?
You're not the one on the hook for a crime this time, buddy.
I guess it was around 1 in the morning on the first floor of our company building.
What was Mr. Delight's wallet doing there?
Anyway, there's nothing weird about that. After all, he works there.
He works there? You mean Mr. Delight?
Sure, here, take a look at this. It's right there in his wallet.
What's this card?
It's a key card for the security company. You see? It's got a serial number on it right there. There's no mistake about it.
Next time we go to the... okay. Serial number on it right there, there's no mistake about it. You said you were working part-time at a security company, right?
Hey, that's right.
Why are you making that scary face? Security company, huh? Something's not quite secure about Larry working there. I need to find out as much as I can about this key card. Oh boy. Inside Ron's wallet, apparently used for the building of his part-time job.
So are you sure about this key card?
Yep, that's the key card we used at the building I work in. For the serial number, this one is for the CEO's office. You need it to get into that room, and every time you use that card, it leaves a record.
It leaves a record?
Yeah, it tells you exactly who entered the room and when. Larry, I need that data. Whoa, slow down, man. Sorry, but that data is off limits to outsiders. If I lost this job, I'd never have a chance with Desi.
It's times like these when I wish lawyers weren't so powerless. Oh my god.
Hey Larry, what about this? What? If you got something to say, then say it already. A blackmail letter?
Do you know anything about this?
What? I don't know anything about Alexis! And that's the truth!
Huh? What?
I can't believe you do this to me! I thought you were my friend! $15,000! I don't have that kind of money! Oh, no, you don't understand! This blackmail letter was sent around the light. Woo! Oh man, you scared me! I almost had a heart attack, you idiot! Wait, I'm the idiot?
Oh, you're right, I am an idiot.
Oh man, I was totally confused because it says KB Security right on the envelope. Yeah, so what? That's where I've got a part-time job at KB Security. What?
Sounds like I should really find out some more about this KB Security company. Well, can we talk with them about it? I'm sure we, yeah. KB Security, the company in the blackmail letter. You know about it?
That's where I work, yeah. In fact, I'm on the job right now.
Huh? So what are you doing here, then?
Well, the boss is away right now, and you know what mice do when the cat's away.
Yes. Anyway, how far is this company?
Let me see. About 30 minutes by car, I guess. Well, if you fly down the road, anyway.
Well, this apartment building is pretty close to Lord Lee Taylor, right? And it would take roughly an hour to go from here to KB Security and back. Ron DeLay was at KB Security when the robbery occurred, then.
Whoa! And he could have sold the sacred urn!
Oh boy.
Hey, Nick, your phone!
Oh.
Hello? Is this the right residence?
Pearls, where are you?
I thought I'd go to Lord Lee Taylor to try and find some more clues, but I'm afraid I've gotten lost. What? Give me that phone, Nick! Pearly, where are you right now? I was walking along and I found myself in front of that person's office.
That person who?
The person who doesn't act his age and always says Zvari when he's excited.
Look at me, it's defective.
Okay, stay right there, we're coming to get you. Alright. I'm a little scared.
Oh boy.
Alright, let's go, Maya. Wait a second, Nick. What? The phone call just now.
Sounded like real cutie.
Oh god. Another one of your special friends?
Say goodbye to Mr. Light for me, would you, Larry?
Larry,
what is wrong with you? Oh, there's a suitcase on the...
Oh. Larry the Lobster. Ah! Mr. Nick! Mr. Maya!
Pearly!
I never thought I'd see the two of you again!
So, is Mr. Ace Detective out of the office?
Yes. When I arrived here, there was no single soul in sight.
Say, Nick, doesn't it look like something's changed since we were here last? Now that you mention it. Yeah, definitely. What's with the big... This bag. I'm sure it wasn't here before.
It looks quite full. I wonder what could be in here.
Hey, Nick, come on, open it up.
Hey, wait a minute. We can't just open this private property.
It'll be such a fuddy-duddy. This is an important investigation.
Oh, that's true, and truth be told, I have to admit, I am kind of curious.
Well, what's in there? Hang on a second. I'm taking it out now.
Whatever it is, it feels kind of hard and smooth.
Well, hello there!
He's here!
Oh boy.
What are you doing, sir lawyer? I'm shocked to see a servant of the court ignoring the law so flagrantly.
I'm really sorry. Maya made me do it.
Nick! I can't believe you! A gentleman never uses a lady as an excuse for his own poor behavior. The real question is, can you afford to waste time lollygagging about here?
What do you mean by that?
Perhaps I should make myself more clear. Tomorrow's trial.
Zvari!
Shall we say the figurative?
Sir William will be dropping his panties before lunch.
Whatever that means, I don't fucking know.
Anyways.
Wow, Nick, sounds like it's gonna be really exciting. What's going to happen at the trial tomorrow that's so dramatic?
Do you know what your biggest mistake so far has been, so lawyer? It was becoming a lawyer in the first place.
That certainly does sound like a big mistake, Mr. Nick.
Tomorrow will be a day to remember. I, Lukatmi, will take the stand. And then Zvari, my testimony will prove to be the undoing of the lot of you! Yes, all of you, I will unmask you as the thieves co-conspirators!
Conspirators?
I hate you.
You click on the defensive, I see. However, it is not I that is your greatest enemy. There is a far more dangerous threat that you will face during the trial.
But what are you talking about?
Sir Lawyer, if you truly are who you say, I'm sure you have heard of him. His name is Godot.
Godot?
You have taken a step down the path of foolishness.
To try to defend a career criminal who deserves nothing less than the death penalty.
Hey, last time I checked, no one knows for sure that Mr. Delight is really the mask.
I hate you.
My dear lady, times may change, but people sadly do not. Well, you understand this when you are more mature.
Who is this Godot person?
It's not surprising that a spirit medium has not heard the name. Godot. The prosecutor whose equal cannot be found in this country but in heaven. Godot. A legend or myth, men pin a lifetime of hopes on the chance to simply meet him.
Prosecutor Godot.
But the best prosecutor in the country isn't Godot, it's Mr. Edgeworth! Isn't that right, Nick?
It's no surprise that a spare medium such as yourself would know nothing of this.
But Ace Prosecutor Miles Edgeworth is currently traveling abroad.
Huh?
In fact, it was Mr. Edgeworth who acknowledged Godot as the best in this country.
And you agree with that?
Most certainly. In fact, you could call him the Lukatmi of the prosecutor's office.
Well, that's good to hear. The prosecution has a fighting chance tomorrow. Mr. Nick, is this Godot really that strong?
I seem to remember hearing about someone like that. Not surprising. Some people spend their entire lives idly waiting for his appearance. It looks like we're done investigating for today.
Sir Lawyer, the stage has been set and all the pieces are finally in place. All that remains now is for the dance to begin.
A new prosecutor, an ace detective, and a thief. This will be one tough trial. Oh boy.
Man, that investigation took forever to finish.
Well, here we are.
Part 2.
AM, District Court. Fan lobby number 4, October
13th. Hey, Nick!
Well, what is it? Is something wrong?
Nah, but did you see all the people here?
No, it's crazy.
Oh, so check out the mask glossy I bought.
Oh boy. You bought this where?
Oh, from the little tents in front of the courthouse. They have all sorts of things for sale.
Oh, selling things at the courthouse?
You know I'm a sucker for this kind of stuff. Come on, I'm guilty! Throw the book at me!
Who's screaming like that?
Oh, Mr. Wright, you made it!
Yeah, I did, but it doesn't look like things are going to get any less ugly for you.
Because I did it! I'm the criminal! Me!
He's at it again.
I sent the calling card to Lordly Taylor! I admit it!
But you don't have the sacred urn, right?
Well, it's true, but that doesn't mean that I didn't commit the crime.
Normally when I say, of course you didn't, I'm being sarcastic, but you...
Yikes!
Anyway, I admit that I'm guilty. So make sure they give me a guilty verdict, please!
Oh, there you are, Ronnie. Bonjour, sweetie. Oh, that's the honey. Bonjour!
Well, actually, I don't really know why I should be speaking French to you.
Leave it all to me, Ronnie. I swear I'll protect you.
You see, actually, the thief is, me. Can I tell you something, Nicky boy? I can guarantee that my Ronnie is innocent. If he's declared guilty, I'll be ever so cross with you. So why are you smiling when you say it?
Well, if you'll excuse me, I've got some errands I need to take care of. I'm counting on you, Nicky boy. Good luck!
To be honest, I really don't know whether Ron is masked a mask or not, but there's only one thing I am sure of. He doesn't have the sacred urn right now.
Mr. Delight, it's time for you to enter the courtroom.
For the time being, I guess I'll have to trust Desiree. It seems as if... Alright, 10 a.m., courtroom number 6.
Judge there, as always.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Ron Delight.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
What about the prosecution? Are you prepared to?
What a stupid question.
What did you say?
Fine. Let me ask you then, Your Honor. Are you ready? Are you ready to pass judgment?
No, I'm not! I will pass judgment after I hear arguments from both sides!
Well, if you're not ready yourself, you shouldn't expect others to be.
That's a rule to live by. That's a rule to live by.
Who are you?
I am Godot, legendary prosecutor. I have never lost a case.
And they play a jazzy theme for him.
He's the one that Detective Atme was talking about.
Another Edgeworth, another Von Karma, or two of them? Another Von Karma, another Edgeworth, oh boy.
He's the one that Detective Atme was talking about.
Yes, your reputation precedes you. What kind of cases have you dealt with so far?
None.
What did you say?
I've never prosecuted a case before.
Wait, what do you mean?
Never? Well, you said you never lost before.
Exactly. I've never lost. I've never won before either.
Then what the hell are you doing here?
Quite arrogant for a beginner, aren't you?
Even the mightiest of redwoods begin their lives as mere saplings.
Yes, but a mask and a court of law?
Ha! Don't you know anything? No matter the man, we all wear masks. Either on our faces or over our hearts.
This guy's the real deal, alright, Nick.
Why does it seem like all prosecutors are the real deal?
So we finally meet, Mr. Phoenix Trice.
Huh?
Nick, is he a friend of yours?
No, I don't have any friends that call me Trite. But he has the smallest... Seems like it. Yeah, I'm sure he does have a small dick.
Just who is this masked man?
I returned from the depths of hell to do battle with you.
Well then, Prosecutor Gobo.
It's not Gobo, it's Godot, Your Honor.
In any case, please give your opening statement.
Opening statement? Those things are not fit for even dogs to consume.
Oh, Jesus. He's already ruthless. Thank you, Ren.
I have only one thing to say before we start. To you, Mr. Trite.
What is it?
Are you familiar with the saying, a chain is only as strong as its weakest link? I wonder how much you can withstand before you and your case break in two.
Okay, what's with this dude? Alright. Godot, age, I don't fucking know. Prosecutor who's shrouded in a mystery. He seems to know me somehow.
Well then, let's hear from the first witness.
Gumshoe, of course.
My name is...
No one has asked for your name, witness. The important thing is what you know. That's all. Start talking. We're listening.
Yes, sir.
All right, witness. First, let's hear about what you know about the thief that stole the urn.
Yes, sir! Mask Damask's crimes. Mask Damask is a master thief that first started his crime spree 6 months ago. So confident, I even sent his calling card before he even commits the crime. This was his fifth heist, and as usual, he sent a card to Lordly Taylor. His pattern is to always go after the most precious art pieces. That's why we're sure it was Mask Damask, sir. It fits his M.O. to a T.
So then the actual identity of this Mask Damask is... Mr. Godot, what are you...
Oh my god! Holy shit.
We're in the middle of a trial here, Mr. Godot!
Blacker than a moonless night, hotter and more bitter than hell itself. That is coffee. I'm sure you can grant me at least as much, Your Honor. Oh, please. Proceed.
Very well, it's only coffee after all.
You can't be letting them sign this early in the trial!
Proceed with your cross-examination, Mr. Wright.
Well, Nick, what are you gonna do? As long as they haven't brought up Mr. Delight's identity, all we can do is show that it wasn't Mask Damask who stole the urn.
No.
Nick, it definitely looks like it was Mask Damask who stole the urn. There's no real evidence either way as to whether Ron Delight's Mask Damask. But... Also, the urn hasn't turned up yet. Let alone in connection to Mr. Delight himself. So even though we know it was Mask Damask that did it, maybe for the time being, as we try to show, it wasn't Mask Damask that did it.
Wrong.
Have you been involved in the investigation from the beginning?
Yep, nobody knows more about the thief than me, pal. It's true, I'm a Zvari author on thieves.
Is that what it means? It's dumb. An author? He's written books about thieves? I think he probably meant to say authority.
The fact that this guy is slipped through even my fingers shows how good he is, pal.
It's easy when those fingers happen to be Butterfingers. So, nobody knows more about the thief than you, huh?
You got it, pal. Except maybe for the thief's mom, that is.
But isn't there someone who knows even more about him than the police?
You don't mean Detective Zvari, do you?
Who is this person, Zvari? He sounds German.
His name is Luke Atme, sir. I guess I shouldn't have made up such a silly name for him.
The hell? I guess he's not all that famous after all. Anyway, it's true that he did manage to retrieve the last item the thief stole.
Oh, I see. It seems you're not the expert you claim to be.
It looks like the thief is toiling me, even now! He's so confident that he sends his calling card before he even gives his crime!
Have you seen all of these so-called calling cards?
Of course I have!
Except... the person in charge of the treasure exhibit never brought their car to the police. So I didn't see this one until after the crime occurred. That's because Detective Atme stopped Miss Andrews from taking it to the police.
Was the calling card that Lordly Taylor received authentic?
Well, all the cards have one common identifying feature. But we're not releasing that information to the general public.
But you're absolutely certain that this card is real?
Gumshoe can't say it out loud, but I bet he's talking about the masked emblem. His fifth heist? You going? Okay. Well, thank you for being here. Yeah, good night to you. And your fifth screw-up, huh? Oh my god.
Objection, pal! That ain't fair. Maybe you can say I screwed up four times. But this last time wasn't my fault. I didn't know about the calling card this time.
You heard me on? Oh boy. Okay. Yeah, I'm getting a bit tired.
I think I'll stop the stream soon.
But I want to get through this cross-examination first. I didn't know about the calling card this time. You of all people shouldn't be chuckling about this, Detective Gumshoe.
I just want everyone here in the courtroom to know something. If you ever get a calling card from this guy, they'll call some stupid private eye. Call your local police right away, got me?
Wow. It looks like he's really got it in for a Detective Atme. Art pieces? Like what, for example?
Well, his first target was the famous Tear of Eminon.
Oh, what's that? Some kind of a specially salty teardrop?
No, sir. It's a blue diamond. A single rare diamond. Next was the crown of Bongara. You know, the thing you put on your head? After that was the left hand of Hades, and then the portrait of Magina, sir. Detective Atme retrieved the portrait of Magina and returned it to the museum.
And the target of his fifth and last robbery was the Sacred Urn, right?
But isn't it difficult for him to dispose of such famous art pieces?
Well, we assume he must have some interval connections.
Somehow, Mr. Delight doesn't look the type. Yeah, he's a little too sunny to be hanging out in the underworld. What do you mean when you say it fits his MO to a T?
I was thinking of asking the same thing myself.
I wish you would listen a little more closely, pal. First of all, there's the calling card. We're 100% certain it's authentic. And then there's the fact that he seemed to know about all about the security system.
and finally his target was an art piece. These are all part of the thief's modus operandi.
And so, since this robbery seems to fit all his conditions?
That's right, it means that Master Mask is behind it! Nick, it definitely looks like it was Master Mask or something.
Oh god.
But wait, hold on. The urn. Priceless, no monetary value. Yep. Can I ask you... Oh yeah, sure, absolutely. Well, my Discord server, but whatever. Here it is, here's the server. Can I ask you a little something, Detective Gumshoe? Just hearing the little in that question is making me nervous. You said that he always goes after the most precious art pieces, right?
That's right, pal.
But there's one problem. That's not what he did in this case. The supposedly priceless art doesn't exactly rise to the level of precious art.
What do you mean?
Nick, how can you say such a terrible thing? No, I meant it from a financial point of view. I mean,
you want to stick around for the raid?
I mean, it wouldn't fetch a good price.
Well, Prosecutor Godot, what is the value of that urn?
The appraisers I spoke to said they couldn't attach a price to it. And I mean that in the worst sense. So, in other words, it was not the kind of item that Mask the Mask would normally go after.
If I understand you correctly, Mr. Wright, you're saying that the theft of the sacred urn was not the work of Mask the Mask.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Actually, all I did was point out the contradiction. The argument made itself, but... Got Discord to work, alright, cool.
Well, first of all, we need to get this issue cleared up. Was this the last robbery the work of Mask the Mask or not? What do you have to say about this, Mr. Godot?
Oh boy. This coffee here, it's my own special blend. I call it Godot number 107. I'm trying to decide whether to cut down on the acidity or this bitterness. That's the only thing I've got on my mind right now. Mr. Trite? What? If you're really a man, you should clean up your own mess. Oh, sorry, but I don't get what you mean. If you're saying it wasn't Mask the Mask that stole the urn, then it must be someone imitating Mask the Mask's methods. A fake.
A fake the mask? Fake the mask. Sounds so ridiculous, but I like it.
Now, before I decide on my coffee, I believe some proof is in order, Mr. Trite. Proof that the person who appeared at Lord Lee Taylor that night was actually a fake.
Though I don't approve of Mr. Godot's behavior, his point is valid. Mr. Wright, we're waiting. It looks like I'm gonna have to prove it. I need proof that person at Lord Lee Taylor that night was, in fact, fake the mask.
Oh, it's not the same.
Send me a friend request? Cool.
The proof is right here.
This looks like a photo taken by a security camera.
Well... Alright, well, since we have proved that point, I think we are good.
Well, just let me make sure I saved it.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I think we're gonna go ahead and raid someone now. Wait, Ren, should I just close the other DM? That you... Alright, cool. Alright, just let me find out who. Alright, I am leaving the Discord chat. Now, let me just pull this up here. Now, I'm thinking... No, let me get back on Twitch. I'm thinking...
Oh man, this really needs to be reloaded. Refreshed. Whatever the words are. Alright, there we go.
I think we're going to read it. I don't know. I don't fucking know.
We're going to... No, don't go back to creator mode. I think we're going to raid, we're going to raid Ray. Going to play in Persona 5 Royal at the moment. That is it this time around. I'll be back tomorrow with more. Yeah. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty much it. This Godot dude, he hasn't won, but he hasn't... This is like his first case ever. Why the hell are we up against him? We're a complete rookie, now he's a complete rookie. Damn. Well, anyways, go show Ray some support and give him a follow if he wants. Well, I guess that's about it. Thanks for hanging out, and cheers, and a big cheers to you for watching. Well, good night. There'll be many more countless nights. What the hell going on with the actual hell? Anyways.